This is Ham Radio Now, the most important amateur radio program on the internet. What the heck? The most important program on the internet. Because I can support saying that just as well as I can support saying the most important amateur radio program on the internet. Can't support them at all. That's for you, Jerry. This is episode 348. Welcome to the 2017 ARRL and TAPR Digital Communications Conference. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. And with this episode, we begin presenting the talks from the 2017 DCC in St. Louis, Missouri, in September 2017, of course. If you're catching this program, let's say early October, then I've got this, the relatively short welcome to the DCC, and I've also got four other talks lined up, all edited, getting introductions from the Friday morning sessions, and you'll be seeing them pretty quickly. I will be editing the rest of the talks and getting them online as quickly as I can, but I expect it to take until late November, maybe December, before they're all done. And that's being optimistic because I've never finished anything before January, and this year it kind of trickled into February. To speed things up, I'm going to record just a generic introduction to most of the talks. And, you know, really the only reason to record any introduction to them at all is to ask you for money. So I didn't run a Kickstarter to support producing the DCC videos this year. I've done that just about every year, and they've mostly been successful, but I, for some reason, didn't do one this year. But with travel, hotels, equipment, editing time, they're kind of expensive to produce. So I'm asking you to make a contribution to Ham Radio Now to pay for me doing this. It's pretty easy. We'll just we'll go to the website, hamradionow.tv, do that click to enter thing here. I don't have the cursor turned on, so let me do this over the shoulder, and you do this click here to enter. It could appear in different places. And then you get to the site, and then you click the pig. That is Arvin, our mascot and chief financial officer. And when you get there, well, let me click that. Gets to our contribution page. When you get there, you've got three options. You've got this one, the Patreon, which is a monthly contribution. Maybe monthly is not what you want to do if you're supporting videos from the DCC. Then there's plain old credit card contribution, and then finally, good old PayPal. You can use a PayPal account if you got one, or a credit card if you don't. And finally, the Kickstarter always offered a $150 contribution, and for that, you would get a little USB drive that had all of the video from all of the programs on it, plus a few extra things. And if you want to get that, then here in PayPal, we've got that option, and you can select it. And while you're on the website, let me note that there is a link to all of the DCC videos, except for the ones back in 2010 when I didn't shoot them, for Ham Radio Now and the old ARVN. It goes all the way back to 2008. It's right here under the episodes menu, and you drop that down and you see TAPR DCC. And here you see a few links. These are the links that they don't show up really well as links because Squarespace doesn't show links like everybody else does in color. Maybe I can find a way to make them do that. In any case, we've got the DCC video from 2011 to the present, and then another link from 2008 and 29. The 2011 to the present, those are the videos that went direct to online. They started on YouTube and then part of Ham Radio Now. The 2008 and 2009 were ripped from the DVDs that I produced in those 2 years. And you'll also see a link to 2010, which I didn't produce, but they're still available on DVDs from TAPR. So I'll click there and find them. And what these links do is take you to simple YouTube playlists. It's the easiest way I could figure to get these things online and make a good list of them that I didn't have to do a lot of work to prepare. You also notice that there's more than DCC videos here. You'll see some TAPR forums, a banquet or two from Dayton, and a few Ham Radio Now episodes like this one with Carl Loffer, the RTL SDR, that weren't specifically TAPR programs, but I thought people interested in TAPR would be interested in those sessions. All right, so now on to the welcome session from the 2017 DCC. And I'm putting this whole session up to give you the full DCC experience. It's got the lunch menus. It's got directions to the bathroom, Wi-Fi password. I'm afraid what you don't get is all the hallway conversations among the hams who attended in person, a visit to the demo room where you can talk to some of the guys who are showing off the stuff, and a chance to ask your own questions of the presenters. Those are the things you get when you become part of the DCC Roadshow and travel to the conference yourself. All right, that's it from me. Let's go to the DCC and TAPR President Steve Bible, N7HPR. And Steve, if you would, give me a quick mic check, and then it's all yours.
Okay. Check, check. One, two. Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to the 36th annual. Let's see. Let's go back. It's, if we're keeping count and if you're collecting, I don't know, trophies, medallions, or whatever, it's the 36th annual ARRR All-in-TAPR Digital Communications Conference. So welcome, and we're glad to have you. My name is Steve Bible, N7HPR. I'm the president of TAPR, and it is the great pleasure of TAPR and the ARRL to produce and bring to you the Digital Communications Conference. However, the conference certainly wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you doing a variety of things. So you, the audience, is very important in the sense that you come and you support the advanced technical side of the hobby. We like to say that we are working on digital techniques. Please don't let the title Digital Communications deter you. We had a lot of people say, oh, I'm not going to go to the Digital Communications Conference because I don't have anything that's digital communications. Like to say that the conference is for digital techniques. So we can do digital communications, digital voice, packet radio, and digital signal processing, and all types of digital techniques that we do that are basically modern day technology with respects to communication. So we want to apply that to our hobby of amateur radio, which in turn, by writing papers, submitting them, getting them published in a paper proceedings for posterity, is advancing the amateur radio of the art, which is part and parcel what TAPR and the fifth pillar of the ARRL is all about. So thank you. So first things first, what do you think the most important thing we should talk about first?
Restrooms.
There you go. What is the Wi-Fi password? So I heard restrooms. So, why, of course. I mean, you need to have the Wi-Fi password before you go to the restroom. Okay, I misspelled it. I can see it's, I got Airport V West, but it's Airport West. So I got an extra V in there. The SSID is Holiday Inn Airport West, and it's open. So basically, you just need to select it. You'll get a web pop-up, and you basically say continue to the internet, and you're on and running. So we've learned very early on, especially since we're high technologists, that if we don't have free Wi-Fi at the Digital Communications Conference, there will be mayhem. All right, second most important thing is you are here, which we are in the main session. So here we are in the Marquette room. I think I've got a little green pointer, so I put a star here. So we're basically in the Marquette, and of course, many of you already came in through the lobby. The bathrooms are around the corner, so you do have to exit to the lobby, take a right, and you'll find the restrooms kind of catty corner over there, so you have to look for them, okay? So we got past the two most important things. All right, let's talk about the lay of the land here. So we've got the demo room really is right on the other side. So the other side of this soft wall is the demo room. We always encourage you that to write a paper and present. But if you're doing that, bring your demos for that, set them up in the demo room. But you don't have to be a presenter to bring your demo. This is an opportunity for you to show off some of the things that you've been working on. So bring those, set them up in the demo room. The demo room is open all day today and all day tomorrow. Okay, so for those of you setting up in the demo room, there'll be a, you'll want to do a teardown later on Saturday night. The demo room's not generally open on Sunday because we have the Sunday seminar. Lots of people either take travel away on Sunday, or they stick around for the Sunday seminar, which we've got a great Sunday seminar presentation this year. All right, so four lunches for today and tomorrow. We're in this area over here, so what we have to do is walk around past the entrance, the front desk of the hotel, and we stay to the right, and then there'll be a door right here. I'm sorry. Yeah, so we're in this. I got my box. It's in this area. Okay, you won't go hungry. How's that? I'm just noticing now that that's magnified, trying to find the doors there. So here's what's for lunch. I'll let you take a look at that. I know you've all had breakfast. You're having coffee right now, so you'll be hungry here in a moment. Now, I figured since we're in St. Louis, we better have a St. Louis barbecue. What do you think? All right. So you got your choice of beef, chicken, or pork, but for some reason, all I could find was chicken legs. I think they lost the rest of the chicken. Haven't quite figured that one out. Okay. The social will be out on the patio. All right, so that'll be later today. So what we're going to do is talks will go until 4 o'clock, at which time we'll break and we'll have play time, which gives you time to spend in the demonstration room and see all the demonstrations. And then right around 5:30, 6 o'clock, we'll segue into the social. And here's what we've got planned for the social. And we hope you're hungry. So it's a great spread. And there will be a bar. So the way we work the bar is you pay for your own alcohol, and then we'll pay for your soft drinks. Okay? All right. Want to do some thank yous. Want to thank Mel Witten. So where's Mel? See outside? There he is. Mel, do you want to stand up so everybody can say, this is Mel. Thank you. Mel, is there anybody else you want to thank in your crew? Because it was you and the local folks. Yeah, come on up. I was going to warn him I was going to do this to him.
Thank you, Steve. I extend my welcome also. It's good to see you. Nice bunch of folks here today, and tomorrow I think you're going to really enjoy the weekend. It's going to be very educational as well as entertaining. So it's been a while since TAPR's been here. Some of us with gray hair or no hair, we may remember in 1982, Slapper had a conference here, and then back in 95, we had the TAPR annual meeting. And back then, DSP was all on our minds, and Tom McDermott here was here at that time, and we were talking about the DSP 93. So TAPR goes way back, always at the state of the art, and I think you'll see more of that here this weekend. So have a great time. If you have any questions I may answer, please look me up. Thank you.
We also want a big shout out to the St. Louis and Suburban Radio Club. Is Bill Carroll in the audience? Nope. Okay, so hopefully tomorrow he'll be here. Or is he planning to attend, Mel? Is Bill planning to attend? Okay, all right. So there are, all right, so raise your hands. Who's here from the club? There you go. Well, thank you very much. And we also want to thank the club. They made a donation to help us pay for the Friday social. So as you're partaking in a cookie, think about the St. Louis and Suburban Radio Club. We also want to do a big thank you to the Missouri Digital Group, and they're providing the coffee. So right out front here, the coffee break for you today and tomorrow is to the Missouri Digital Group. So who is here from the Missouri Digital Group? Thank you, you guys. So pat these two on the back, okay? Not too hard. All right, let's give a shout out to Gary for doing phenomenal job ever since about 2008 on doing videos for the Digital Communications Conference. I think it's been wonderful. Bring the pig. Yeah, bring the pig. Is that the DCC is now much more expanded by the fact that the videos are up on YouTube. We have this man to thank.
Thank you very much. We'll do a little bit of fundraising and a little bit of instruction. This is the fundraising. You all know Arvin. He'll sit up here. We didn't do a Kickstarter this year, mostly just because I didn't get around to it. Just been way too busy. So ordinary contributions through the website, either PayPal, credit card. There's a Patreon, which is monthly. If you're just supporting DCC, you probably don't want to do that. But that's the place to go. Or just, you know, if you got some loose change, stick it in Arvin up here. Now the instruction part. This is a television show. It's not just an in-person conference. Wow, what a crowd. This is awesome. You guys in St. Louis, get up early. A big part of the program is Q&A, questions and answers. And we want to get you on camera and on mic when you're asking questions. So we got a couple of mic runners. Mic runners, stand up, turn on your mics, and tell everybody who you are for our initial two mic runners. Go ahead.
Armin, number one. KD0PXF.
I don't think your mic is on. I'm not hearing you. It's on? Okay.
KD0PXF.
Okay. And?
WD0FCH.
Okay. So if you got a question, raise your hand. One of these guys will find you. They'll hand you a microphone. We would like you to stand up. If you're in witness protection, you know, hunker down. And the reason for standing up is, first of all, I can find you with the camera, so I can, you know, get your close-up, Mr. DeMille. And so everyone else can see you. The reason for the microphone is so everybody else can hear you and the television can hear you. There will be a point where, in some discussion, things are going to get bat back and forth really quick. Like, could you back up one slide? You don't have to wait for a microphone. You can just holler that out for something quick. But if you're going to pontificate for a bit, or if you've got a question that is more than three or four words worth to answer, raise your hand, get a mic runner to you. And the presenter's in charge. They'll call on you, but you know, we'll get you on camera and be part of the show. I think that's it. Appreciate everybody for watching Ham Radio Now, for the TAPR conference and everything else that we do. And Steve, I'm done.
All right, fantastic. Thank you, Gary. So if ever you have friends or family that don't know what the DCC is, you can refer them to the YouTube videos and they can select a talk and see what the DCC is about. We certainly like to have them present. So to get these talks out to the rest of the world, we really do need to consider contributing. And it's not a lot of money. Okay, so it's just a few dollars and that really helps get the rest of this conference out to the rest of the world. All right, so let's talk a little bit about the schedule. As you came in and checked in, you got a proceedings. There's 8 papers that were submitted this year. 7 of those are speakers on Saturday for tomorrow. So what's interesting about the Saturday lineup is it'll be the presenters of the papers that are submitted in the proceedings. Today is quite interesting because the speakers are pretty much aligned with digital voice. So it's just an interesting fact about the Digital Communications Conference and that the topics that are talked about are pretty much selected by those of you submitting papers and attending. If you want to kind of get a snapshot of where the technical side of amateur radio is, take a look at the DCCs and take a look at the talks that have been submitted, and that'll give you a sense of what's going on at the moment. And we don't really have a theme. It pretty much creates itself through the submission of papers. So today is pretty much digital voice, but what's really going to be fascinating tomorrow is the ham sci. And we'll hear from Nathaniel and his group of researchers and also other amateur scientists participating in the ham sci. All right, so A lot of folks will ask questions about where it is next year. I'll announce it tomorrow during the TAPR annual meeting at the end of the talks tomorrow. So we do have a location, so I'll let you know that, but I'll announce what the location is tomorrow. So 2018 is to be announced tomorrow. 2019 is lining up to be Detroit, Michigan. We still need a location for 2020. All right, so if anybody would like to bring the DCC to their area, please have a chat with me. And then 2021 is 40, number 40. And we will strive very hard to take that to the Tucson area. Okay? So Scotty and I, living in the Phoenix area, will travel down to Tucson and do some scouting out of some locations in the Tucson area. Hamvention. It's not too early to think about Hamvention. Or maybe it is. Okay. So would you like to make a presentation or a talk at Hamvention in 2018? TAPR has a very large block of time in the forums on Friday morning. Let us know if you have a topic or talk that you'd like to give, and we can consider putting you on the speaker schedule. And then would you like to be at the TAPR booth showing off some projects or some of the work that you've been doing? We have a pretty sizable booth at the Hamvention. So if you'd like to be there, please come and talk to somebody of the TAPR board of members or myself. Okay, any last minute questions before we kick it off? Okay, so if the presenters with your talks haven't got with Scotty, raise your hand. He's the guy in the red shirt there. Scotty's coordinating getting the presentations on the presentation laptop, or if you choose to use your own laptop, get with Scotty so we can check and make sure that you can connect up to the projector. It is a very new projector. We can do 4x3 or 16x9. And so we shouldn't have any problems. We just want to work ahead of it so we can thwart any problems ahead of time. George, raise your hand. George here is doing audio. And of course, Gary's doing video. So that is the crew, so to speak. Thank you. All right, I have one more thing. It's quite important, actually. So we had one speaker today, Mark Miller and 5RFX, had to cancel today due to illness. We figured we'd have some cancellations due to hurricanes, but we have one to an illness. So the talk at 1 p.m. to 1:45, right after lunch. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to do lightning talks during that time. So what is a lightning talk? It is a 5 minute maximum. 5 minutes, that's all you get. Maximum of 3 slides or no slides, but you only get 5 minutes. What we're going to do is we want to select 5 lightning talks and give them during that 45 minute slot. So here's what you're going to do. You have a pad of paper. If you have a lightning talk topic, I want you to write the title of it here, your name and your call sign, and give it to me. And we're going to form a little impromptu committee, and we're going to select 5 talks. So you've got between now and lunchtime, lunchtime, to do that and get that to me so I can get back to you and say, okay, your talk is selected, and we'll line you up, okay? 5 minutes maximum. Okay, any questions on that? Well, at our age, I don't know if I want to relive those times again. All right, I'm going to turn it over to Scotty to line up John, and then we'll introduce John and we'll get going with the first talk. Thank you, folks.
I always do this to Scotty, make him go deaf. This is an attention-getting device for synchronizing cameras.
Oh, thank you, sir. I'll have another.